Hello, welcome back for another episode of RocketCraft.
Editor Jerry here. I actually did a bit of a boo-boo while recording this, and all of my audio for a lot of the clips went a bit skew-iff, so I decided to use OBS for something I wasn't doing Minecraft for, and it messed up all my settings, and I didn't realise till after I'd done a lot of the build. So you'll have to bear with me, and hopefully I've had to re-record a load of audio, but it'll all make sense. It's all sorted now, so the next episode after this should be okay. But let's get back to it. I know I haven't been around for a bit. Kind of had a bit of a lull. It happens. It happens to us all. But I'm back. I'm back at the base. Ready. I'm going to start building things again. And to be honest, the one thing that you can see, not really a lot has happened. For me, it's been a while as well since I last recorded. And I haven't done anything since. Whoops. But the one thing that's got me back into it is this. So this little thing here was doing my head in for ages. I could not, for the life of me, get the right texture in. And after watching a good old friend over on Hermitcraft B-dubs, he started doing a bit of terraforming and he used these block palette. And it does work really well. So you've got some acacia in there, you've got tuff. And then obviously that links in with the moss. And to be honest, I'm quite impressed with that. Quite happy with it. And what I've done as well is I've put some darker basalt in here just for the floor. It's going to be the entryway into the cave. I haven't done the cave yet. That's going to be this episode. I'm going to do, hopefully, fingers crossed, I'm hopefully going to do all of this here. And I'm going to turn it into an abandoned mine shaft for now. Just so I've got something, so it's not just this very blank cave, say. Yeah. Hopefully get rid of some of these mushrooms as well. Allison's mushrooms are spreading everywhere. Oh. Three-headed horse for a second. Next on the list, after I've done that, is this bridge. Because I'm sick and tired of having to fly or you know, get over to this bit over here and then have to climb up bit by bit by bit by bit by bit. But yeah, so that's going to be this episode. And I'm also, I know, there's more. I'm also aiming to get those market stalls down there finished as well. So then that area, technically complete, apart from I've got to the boat at the back. I haven't thought of an idea for that yet. We also, our neighbour, Sonic's been on. She started her base as well. And it's looking pretty good, I might have got to say. Yeah, look at these wall patterns. It's so good. It's simple, but it's really illuminated just by two sea lanterns. So, these market stands, what we're going to do. How many we got? Can I split it into four smaller ones or do two bigger ones? You know, I might do this as two small ones. I might do this as like a bigger, like storage-esque, with like barrels and, you know, that kind of haughty looking stand. And then round here, I think I might do this as like fish. Got some fish? I think so. We're on a dock. You can have some fish at a dock. I might do that as like a little fish stall and then, yeah, we'll figure all that out. So yeah, it has been a while since I've last recorded, but I have been sorting this out and gathering some materials on the side a little bit, not much. They've got some acacia in there. And here, the salt, because obviously I was doing the entryway into the cave. Let me just gather up some materials and I'll be back in a second. Right, so we've got some materials now. Here's some of the bits I got. Not much, but we'll make do. We'll try and get some base frames up and then we can decorate them later. I've got a couple of little bits of decoration there, but we'll sort all that out. You can kind of see I've got three different themes going on here. So I've got kind of like a darker one, a lighter one, and then like an earthier one as well. And then for the roof, I might do a dark prismarine one, which will link in with my little carriage over there. So that can kind of be, could be their carriage really. So all storytelling, so you kind of want to link some of your stuff, so hopefully that carriage then will link in with one of these. I might even link it with this one as the closest one to it. And then round here, I think I'll do the lighter acacia one, and then yeah, let's just start building. These little market stands, very common. All right, mud balls. Oh, an acacia, I reckon, on top. So I've got a little bit of herb going on. And then I'll put another one of these on the top. Bring it back. And then from there, I think that's kind of a good height roof level that can kind of go up to these lanterns. That's what I'd like to do. Yeah. Like that. Don't know if I'm going to do any sides, because obviously you need to walk in, but I might do a little, kind of a bit of a veranda, like right over there, and call this up. Bit of depth. Plus, I might also be able to put signposts and things off these. Work quite well. So I'm keeping these iron bars in, because it kind of looks like a tie. It's like tied back to the wall. There we go, first little market stall in. I quite like that. Might change this one half slot. Gosh, there we go, yeah, that's better. Like that. There we go. Start of a little market stand. So for this one, I'm going to go for a bit of a darker theme, and I'm going to put a bit of detail in the back wall. So I've used the alcoves on the previous fishing stall, and for these ones, I want to use the same bit of storage, but obviously these are two separate stalls. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some fence posts to kind of tie them all together, but I'm also going to use mud that I also used on the fishing one, so it kind of all links together, but they're still their own different stalls. Raise the back of this one just up by a block, because I want to make this into a slanted roof. I kind of like that these as well are like two odd numbers, so this one over here is smaller than the one on the right. For the front of these market stalls, I'm going to do it in calcite. That's to link it with a carriage that I built up top. I'm going to leave a block open on the left-hand side, just so you can walk in and, you know, access everything. And then on the front, I'm going to add some buttons, just like I said, just to tie it all in with the materials, because there's warped wood. And then this surface here will then give you a nice little spot where you can sell all your goods from. But I'm going to detail all of this in a bit. I'm just going to do the main build, and then after that, I'll detail it all up. So, between clips, I was sorting out some inventory. I've got some shulkers ready to decorate up our market stalls. And this happened. Yep, that's right. Glyph got me. I think it's been 10 people since the last time I got tagged. It's been that long. It's back. I've got it again. I've got to wear this derpy head. And to be honest, the way Glyph did it, I was busy. I had my headphones on. I was chilling, building. Stuck up on me. So I'm getting away with this. So I'm going to call upon some friends. I've sent a little invite out, and hopefully I can get it back. But I've got to get rid of it. So let's go over to the castle and have a quick pooch at the bounty. Who's got a tasty one? Who is going to be my next target? Anyway, I think I picked a target, but I'm going to go through detailing all these stalls up now. So go through this shulky, you can see I've got a load of fishing bits and bobs. So I've got some fishing rods, some mannequins, and various nautical things that we can decorate this up with, even some decorative pots. This one over here is going to be a flower shop, so we've got a load of different flowers and pots and decorative pots, just to kind of flesh it out a little bit. And the final one, I think this is going to be a crafting station / blacksmith place where you can get gear, or, you know, just like a seller of armour and stuff. I haven't really decided yet, but once the docks, and I think it'll flow quite good. Oh,
Right, we've got to deal with this cave now. So obviously I've started the entryway with some basalt and the various texturing that I'm going to use in here. But obviously I've dug this all out and this is a 3x3 kind of just, it was just a rough guide really to see what we could do with the space. I've opened this bit up a little bit and then through here, it kind of gets a bit narrow and curves a little bit, but I'm going to do a load of terraforming in here to kind of open it up into little caves and various little bits and bobs, so it isn't as flat. But I'll do that now, so with a little bit of movie magic, and just like that. So I've been working in here, and you can see I've dug this out a little bit. So while digging, I actually found a bit of a natural cave down there. But what I'm going to do is do as like a suspended bridge that goes round the corner and over this, and then you can look down into the cave. I've made it look as rough as possible so it doesn't look, you know, that I've carved it out. But yeah, I think it's going to work well with what I'm thinking. So if we just pop down here, up here, I've kind of made this a little bit more like it's been mined out, and we put the pillars in across, and then I've done another little one here, just a bridge across. This I've made a little bit wider just so we can get the walls in, because a 3x3 wouldn't have really worked with the mine shaft design. It'd been tiny otherwise. And then in here, I've made a big area over here where I'm going to do a little bit of a pond or, you know, overgrown sort of thing. And then, yeah, then I'll fill it all in with various like greenery and stuff. And then over here, I'm thinking of building something for the Mushroom Queen. So obviously there's mushrooms all in here anyway, and it's inspired me to make her a little home. So I think this is where she can do all of her little potions and gathering and various things. So that's going to go in there. And then through here, I'm going to obviously do the same pattern as I did over there. And it's just going to be all textured out, very similar to what I've done at the front. So yeah, let's get on with it. So, while trying to collect some materials to do the next little bit of the build, my target came along to get rid of this derpy head. So, let's go get him. So glad I got rid of that tag head. It's the most annoying thing, and Leslie was a target of mine for months.
So I'm so glad I passed it on. Anyway, get back to this. As you can see, I've done more. I've put the mushrooms back in, but we've still got this little spot here, which I'm going to do something for the Mushroom Queen, or aka the old hag, Alison. And I think I'm going to put a bit of lore in here that she comes in here and she harvests mushrooms and stuff. So yeah, I can't wait. And let's get straight onto that, I think, now with another little time lapse.
So the cave is finally complete, but I need one finishing touch and it'll be perfect. There's somewhere in here. Ooh, this room's been updated. Looking nice. Where is she? There she is. Perfect. So the cave is finally complete, and as I've changed some of the lighting, actually, you'll notice we're going through, it's a bit darker, so I've got some glow lichen about, just to give you that bit of a more atmospheric. And as you walk through, a bit dark, and here it is, we've got the mushroom house. But what I needed was this. The Mushroom Queen herself in her natural habitat, brewing potions and putting spells on everybody. We've got a nice little painting. They've got a new pack installed now of the swamp, where she belongs. Don't know what mischief she's going to get causing in here. But yeah, we should carry on, as you can see. It was a small build, but I think it does it justice, really. You can kind of tell it's like an inbuilt mushroom. But going around, I've put some low lighting, glow lichen about. Like this. And then we've got the bridges. So we've got magma underneath, but what I've done is I've put some glow lichen under the bridges and round the magma to give off more light than just the magma does, because it doesn't actually give off that much light source. But there's no torches or anything down there, it's just glow lichen. And I think it's worked out really well. So yeah, this now goes all the way around and out the other side. We're getting somewhere! So when I said I was going to do the bridge in this episode, but it's getting on already, and I've done so much, but yeah, that's what it is at the moment. So I'll work on that next episode, I think, because the cave itself, I think, is looking great, and I've spent a lot more time in it. So, but there is one thing I want to do, actually, before we end this episode, because word on the street is we've got a mayor. So let's go and have a look at what's been going on. Ram Project offering reward for safe return of Sonic's dog. Who stole Sonic's dog? Right, so I've heard over in Rocket Town there is a new mayor. And I've heard they've set up over in what was DJ's Starter House. Oh, Ram Project again. I wonder who this is. Subtle. So yeah, Sonic is now the mayor of the server, I believe. And there's been some shenanigans going on. Is it in here? Yeah. The Nitwit Slayer. I'm a suspect! What? I haven't done anything! Innocent until proven guilty, Sonic. Innocent. But I may have some information on the Nitwit Slayer. And they're not on the suspect list. Yeah, those Nitwit heads. I've been seeing those appear. I'm a suspect again. What for? The dog napper? I swear. I do one little prank and people think I'm the suspect for everything. It's not true. I'm innocent. See, I've just been building my cave. You've seen that. So apparently this book at the front. Welcome to Mayor Sonic's house. The mayor and the Mushroom Queen. The Mushroom Queen? What's she doing? That's why we want you to have your say and help keep our server safe from crime. Here's an explanation how to use each box. Suggestion box. Have any ideas how to improve things? Any events? No. Special recognition as someone. Ooh. Might be able to do that. Nominate somebody. They win some amazing prizes. Crime box. Had a dog kidnapped. Witness of theft. All crimes are put in the. Ooh. Well, I didn't witness a theft, but I definitely witnessed something going on with some nitwits. And not these pair behind me either. So I think I'll put a little suggestion in and see if Sonic gets back to me. I have nitwit slayer info. Jerry. Too many letters. Seen the nitwit slayer. Jerry. Hopefully this isn't incriminating myself, saying that I am the nitwit slayer. I'm not. It just means that I've seen them, and there's not enough characters on these pieces of paper. Right, where is it? Crime box. Oh, it's gone. There's hoppers underneath there. Right, hopefully she'll get back to me. But I think that's where we're going to round it up for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed the builds. There's going to be more to come. Yeah, apologies for the audio issues. They've been a nightmare. But hopefully it's all sorted now. So, without further ado, I will see you in the next one. Bye!